Hello everyone, my name is Pallavi Chakole from Civil Engineering Department YCC Nagpur, along with the supporting staff RS Mahamudesan. This is the apparatus of single purchase scrap. The aim of our experiment is to determine the efficiency and law of machine of single purchase scrap. Of single purchase scrap. In that single purchase scrap, there are the two axle. First one is your effort and second one is your load. Along with that, there are the pinion and spur. Smaller wheel is known as a pinion wheel and larger wheel is known as a spur wheel. In that experiment, first we have to require the various apparatus for performance of this experiment. The apparatus required are the loads, the weight box and the pan. For performing this experiment, before starting the procedure, we have required certain observation. For that observation, first you have to calculate, these are the teeth. First you have to calculate the number of teeth on that pinion wheel, that is known as a T1. Then second one, you have to calculate the number of teeth on the spur wheel, that is known as a T2. For T1, you have to calculate the number of teeth. Likewise, the number of teeth on the pinion wheel is 20, and number of teeth, as we counted the number of teeth on the spur wheel, that are total number of teeth is 100, that is known as a T2. Second thing we have to calculate, that is the diameter of the effort wheel and diameter of the load drum. Diameter of effort wheel is known as a T1 and diameter of effort load drum is known as a T2. For calculating diameter T1, first you have to calculate the circumference of that effort wheel. From that circumference, we can calculate the diameter of the effort wheel. Second one, we have calculated the circumference of that load drum. From that circumference of load drum, we can calculate the diameter of that load drum. Okay, these are the initial observations which are required for the performance of experiment. Now we will conduct the experiment. For the experiment, first we have to put the weight in the load drum. For the first reading, we put the weight of 500 grams. This is the effort wheel. Effort wheel having the string attached with the pan. This is the string attached with the pan. For the weight of 500 gram, we will put the effort on the effort pan. Our is to calculate the effort required to lift the load. We will add the weights in the effort pan till your effort pan moving downward. First we will add the weight 50 grams. Gradually we are increasing the weight in the effort pan till your effort pan moves downward. As your effort pan moves downward, this total weight is the effort required to lift the weight 500 grams. For this reading, we require total effort is 50 gram plus 20, that is the total 70 grams effort is required to lift the load 500 gram. We will add the 70 plus the weight of pan, that is the 66 gram, that is the total effort required to lift the weight 500 gram. This is your first reading. After first reading, we will take the second reading. For the second reading, that is for the load of 1000 gram, we will apply the load on the effort pan. Gradually we are increasing the load till the effort pan gets moved downward. Now you will see that the effort pan gets moving downward. So that is the total effort required to lift the weight 1000 gram. So these are the two readings. Likewise, you are taking total 5 readings in the interval of load 500 gram. It is single purchase scrap. These are the initial observation. First one is your T1, that is teeth on the pinion wheel. Next one is D2, that is the teeth on the spur wheel. D1 is the diameter of the effort wheel. D2 is the diameter of the load drum. From these observations, we can calculate the value of Vr. Vr is the velocity ratio. The formula is T2 by T1 multiplied by D1 by D2. From these observations, we can calculate the value of velocity ratio. After calculating the velocity ratio, next one is your observation table. In observation table, first one is your first column is your serial number, then load, effort, mechanical advantage, efficiency, then effort loss in friction, and last one is your ideal effort. Serial number, we can calculate the force reading. Serial number is 1. Load applied is 1000 gram. For that load, effort required is your 136. Then third one is your mechanical advantage. The formula of mechanical advantage, again load upon effort. You have the value of load 1000, effort is 136. You get the value of mechanical advantage. Next, you have to calculate the efficiency. The formula of efficiency is MA upon VR, that is the mechanical advantage upon velocity ratio. You know the value of mechanical advantage, that is 7.35. upon velocity ratio value is 17.72, you get the value of efficiency. Next is effort loss in friction. It is denoted by PR. The formula of effort loss in friction is P minus W upon VR. P is your effort, that is 136, minus W is your load, that is 1000, divided by VR. VR is your velocity ratio, that is 17.72. You get the value of effort loss in friction. Last one is your ideal effort. Ideal effort, it is denoted by PI. Formula of PI is P minus PR, that is the effort minus effort loss in friction. You get the value of ideal effort. This is your first reading. Then likewise, we are taking 4 more readings. For second reading, we take the load, that is the 1500, then for 2000, then 2500, and last one is for 3000. For that load, these are the effort required. Likewise, we can do the calculation for remaining 4 readings. We will go towards the result. For the result, we will draw these 3 graphs for single purchase graph and also for the differential excellent bill. We will draw the first graph. First graph, we will plot load versus effort. We will take the reading of load on the horizontal axis and reading of effort on the vertical axis. From these reading, we will draw the straight line covering maximum points intersecting on the y-axis. Then the intercept, the distance from that point to the origin is the distance, that is the value of C. Now from the straight line, we consider any 2 points. From that 2 points, we draw a single triangle, and from that triangle, we calculate the slope of this particular graph. Then second graph, that is the load versus ideal effort. We will take the reading of load on the horizontal axis and ideal effort on the vertical axis. The nature of graph is the straight line from origin. Then we will draw the third graph. Third graph is between the load versus efficiency, load on the horizontal axis and efficiency on the vertical axis. This graph is the nature of curve. From this gate increasing up to the certain point, and after that point the efficiency of the machine gate gradually decreases. From these three graphs, we will calculate the result. In result, first point is VR, that is the velocity ratio, which is already calculated in the observation. Then second one is your efficiency. In the observation table, you calculate the efficiency of each reading. After the calculating the efficiency of each reading, we will take the average of that efficiency. That value we will write down in the efficiency. Then third one is, that is the law of machine, law where P is your effort, M is your slope, W is your load, and C is constant. The value of M is getting from the first graph, Then W is as it is plus C. C is the constant. The value of C is also getting from the first graph. After putting all these values, your left hand side should matches with the right hand side. Suppose we will consider the first reading. The first reading effort value is equal to the right hand side.